Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I got a special YouTube video for you guys. I'm gonna take you through one of my workouts today. I'm currently training for the Tuba City Half Marathon that's gonna be happening this coming Sunday. So I actually just got off work, and so I do need to get in a workout and get some footage in for you guys. Today I actually have a recovery run because yesterday I did do about 4 miles and now I'm pretty tired, so it's just a recovery run to recover from yesterday. And I'll go ahead and record some of my workouts that I'll have later in the vlog for you guys to see what I typically do to prepare for something like this as well. So let's go ahead and get the vlog started.
Hey guys, welcome back. So I just got done with my run. I ran about 1.25 miles just to keep it light and allow myself to get comfortable running the pace that I'm currently set at. And so right now, I just want to show you a little bit about what I usually target on when I'm getting ready to go into my half marathon. I know it's gonna be completely a little bit different from a lot of other people who might do something a little bit different. This is just what I typically like to do to help myself get ready for. Right now, I'm just gonna do a little bit of arms, making sure I feel good, making everything's okay. So I got my weights here to show. I'm using my 15-pound weights. I don't know if you can see that, but there you go. I'm using my 15-pound weights just to do a little bit of my arms. Again, a little bit of shoulders, making sure everything's okay. Right now, I'm just gonna do a little bit of shoulders, I guess. I don't know what they would call them, but I mean, it's what I do.
Feeling my way through the darkness. I don't know how you guys do sit-ups. I certainly do mine's a little bit different. I've been taught many different ways, but you know, do the sit-ups the way you know how and you guys would be good to go, okay? So let's go ahead and get started.
Where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand.
Now, I like to use this because it definitely helps me with my sit-ups.
So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding.
Again, there's many others you can do, but you know, I'm just doing what I can to keep me loose for my half marathon, making sure everything's working well. So that's about it. I'm gonna probably get in another workout again on Friday, you know, keeping everything light, making sure everything is working fine, not pushing myself too hard, because you know, in the next couple days your body is gonna be tested, especially if you're training for a half marathon. But yeah, that's about it. So again, Friday I'll probably do another, I would say 2.5 miles, maybe 3 miles, just to, you know, get used to the pace again. But on Saturday, you know, I definitely am gonna be drinking a lot of water, but you know, in any case, you should be drinking a lot of water, making sure your body's hydrated, make sure you're eating right, and also making sure you're feeling yourself. When I get home, I'll probably do maybe about 1 mile, just, you know, get used to the elevation, because you know, the Tuba City and the Phoenix area do have different elevations, so that is also going to play a huge part in this game. So I'll go ahead and do that, and then we shall see where we end up. So we'll see you guys in a bit. Good morning, everybody. Today is race day. It is officially Sunday, and we are ready to get this run in today. I'm really excited, if you can't tell. but I feel really, really good. Just finished doing like a really quick warm-up run. Race doesn't begin for another 10 minutes, but you know what? We're gonna go out there, we're gonna kill it. And I hope some of the footage I'm able to capture today, you guys are able to, you know, be able to say, you know, you experience a little bit about how a race starts and how, you know, some of the things you would go through. But some things I did to prepare for today was drink an enormous lot of water. I actually was drinking, I would say, a little over 2 gallons of water yesterday, so I feel really good to be running today. And I did carb up, and you know, I had all my race gear ready to go, some good shoes, some good socks, some running tights. Right now it's a little cool, but I'm gonna take them off just before we start so I can make sure that I don't overheat myself and I get tired. So I'm gonna take these off before I start running. But that's pretty much all I have to say right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and make my way back to the starting line and then just finish my last couple stretches there and then get ready to take off. So I hope you guys enjoy the experience. We'll see you guys in a bit.
Enjoy your neighbors.
Before my time is up.
Hey, here we go.
Let's go.
Hey YouTube fam, I just made it to the halfway point, starting back to the finish line. My pace is going pretty good. Right now, I'm running about a 10:30, but it's going pretty good. Just have to keep pushing my pace and catching people. So, it's going good. So, right now, I'm just trying to catch people. What I mean by that is I pick a runner ahead and try to match their pace and push it. So I'm gonna keep playing this game until we make it home. I'll see you guys in a bit. Hey guys, thanks so much for coming back this week. I really appreciate you guys' support and watching my videos. I just wanted to recap really quick because this past Sunday, I wasn't able to, you know, finish up and recap at the finish line. But, you know, it was a really great experience overall. I just, you know, I really, really love running. It's something that, you know, I'm able to, you know, find peace in. And, you know, it's become more of a meditation for me. Ever since I started running about two, three years ago, I really found a liking for running. And now that I'm actually a couple races in and I actually do have some medals here to show for that, it's become more of a thing I find to liking here, only because, you know, it's something, like I said, it's more of a meditation for me. It's more of something that I can escape and just, you know, have control over, to just, you know, achieving things in a real-time experience. And it's just, it's something that I really love doing, and it's something I found the passion for that I never really set into something in a while. So I actually really love running now. It's something that I make sure I'm able to do with my everyday workouts. But today is Monday. I am really tired. I basically took today to, you know, recover from my race. My legs were really, really sore when I woke up this morning. Just a lot of stretching today, a lot of water, and just, you know, really recover from this race. Because just to go over a little bit about what I experienced during this race, you know, I did run it last year. Last year was a really good race. The first, I would say, maybe 3 miles, it was a lot of downhill terrain. So there was a lot of, you know, elevation changes going downhill. And then going into the, I should say about maybe 4, 5, 6 mile mark, that's where the terrain sort of got flat last year. But this year was actually a lot different, where the terrain was, you know, we went down 3 miles and then, you know, terrain was sort of like going up and down within the next 4 or 5 miles. And so with that, you know, I just had to stick with it, make sure I was able to keep my pace. And for the most part, I was able to. I'm pretty satisfied with the time that I did finish in. And so, you know, with the hill workout I did do last week, it was something that helped me a lot, only because when I got to the 3 mile mark, I seen the downhill terrain. And then when I got back to that mile marker again, I was able to, you know, actually run up the hill and be able to, you know, just stick to my pace that I wanted. So it was really exciting that, you know, I was able to be strong in that case. And a lot of my workouts did come in handy where I was, you know, just able to actually just, you know, go on that incline and be able to just, you know, keep the pace that I wanted, finish in the time that I wanted, and be able to, you know, catch people that I was intending to catch. And so just to go over a little bit of that, because I know when I was running, I did say I wanted to playing that catching sort of game. What I mean by catching is you're basically picking a runner in the distance. You're matching their pace, but in that pace, you're actually trying to move yourself further and closer to that person to catch them. And then eventually when you do pass them, then you want to look for that next person you want to catch. And so that's pretty much what I was playing, a mental game and also a physical game. Through the last, I would say maybe, 4 miles, I was just catching people and making sure I could pass them. Or if there's someone that, you know, I felt like had a really good pace and I wanted to pace off of, then I made sure I kept that pace with them. And then I found the next person I could chase. So it was a really good experience. You know, I really love running back home, especially, you know, with the scenery that we have out in Tuba City and running in Monavi area. It was really, really awesome. So I guess, you know, I really want to thank, you know, the Tuba City chapter government for putting on the half marathon once again. It's something that I really enjoy doing. And, you know, it's something that I hope that I can continue to do, you know, as the years come along. It's something that they can continue to do because, you know, it's great. Running's good for you. It's something that brings people together. And it's also something, you know, that will keep people healthier. So I really love that our community is able to do that for the community members and also people that, you know, live in the neighboring town. So just wanted to, you know, thank you guys for watching and also just recap and end the video for you guys. But definitely I invite you guys to, you know, come back onto my social media platforms with like Instagram, Facebook, or if it's Twitter, you know. Come back and, you know, share some of your stories. And also, if there's questions that you guys want to, like, ask me about the half marathon, you guys can definitely leave them in the comments section. Or if you want, send me a message in my email. I do have my email in the description as well. Let me know what your experiences are. And then also, if you want, send me questions, because I definitely want to see what you guys want me to share. And also if there's things that you guys want me to answer, or if there's an experience that, you know, where do I begin, or what do I do when I get to this point in my training, you know, those are some of the questions I want to be able to help share. And if I can't find the answers, I'll help direct you to finding those answers, because, you know, running is fun. Running is something that we should all love to do, and it's something that, you know, as Native American people, it's something that we always cherish in doing. So I hope that you guys continue to watch my videos. I really appreciate them. If you're new to my channel, thanks so much for coming into my channels and taking a chance and watching my videos. I do appreciate it. But also, I've been playing with my metal for a while. Just wanted to show you guys, this was what I got. It's actually really cool, you know. Just with the red pattern here, like, this is a, you know, a pattern of a Navajo basket, and then obviously the Tuba City, and then at the bottom it says, the bike race and half marathon 2019, and I'm trying to let the camera focus. I'm not too sure if it will, but at the bottom, there are like little purple dinosaur feet. And so if you guys don't know, Tuba City's sort of famous, I should say, for the dinosaur tracks, only because they are there. And one of these days, you know, I hope my vlog does take me there so I can show you guys what those actually are. But if you guys have a chance, I mean, look it up on Google, look it up on YouTube, because, you know, there's some videos that show them and there's also pictures. And, you know, that's just one of the landmarks that are in Tuba City, as well as, you know, the Castle Rock there. So definitely wanted to show you guys that my Nibiru added to my collection, and, you know, just share my happiness for running them, share my, you know, my gratefulness for the Tuba City chapter for always, you know, putting on a great and awesome event to share with everybody else. So I'm glad everyone enjoyed themselves, because it was another huge turnout again. But yeah, definitely subscribe to my channel. And if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it. And let's make this channel something that a lot of people can, you know, look forward to. So I appreciate you guys watching my videos. Have a great one.